So the new Judas Priest album dropped a few days ago, and after listening to it a few times all the way through, I can say that it's a top-notch heavy metal album. It's just one face-melting song after another, and the band's performance is particularly impressive. And I don't just mean from a technical standpoint. These guys are playing with so much energy and passion that it's really hard to believe this is a band that released its first album 50 years ago. And that's one of the things that, in my opinion, makes this album so special and so meaningful to us metal fans. The weight of its legacy. Because what Judas Priest have done is they've created an album that sounds really fresh and contemporary, and at the same time bears various markers of the band's style and sound throughout the decades, including some really cool references to iconic songs, like Panic Attack has elements of Painkiller, and that turbine sound from Turbo, that's just all kinds of awesome. The title track has something of Ram It Down, and even a hint of Exciter in the pre-chorus. Devil in Disguise harkens back to Metal Gods, and As God Is My Witness reminds me of Leather Rebel from the Painkiller album. And let me clarify that when I make a reference or a comparison to an older song, I'm not suggesting they're recycling material or anything like that. Every artist has their own distinct preferred patterns and various stylistic markers that make up their sound as a whole. Being able to recognize these is very helpful in understanding a band or artist's musical style. So when you hear me point these things out, that's the reason. The musicianship on this record is truly outstanding. Scott Travis's drumming is tight and punchy, and I love that his snare hits still have that great snap. Ian Hill's still one of the best bass players in metal. The guy holds down the bottom end so steady and with such fluidity, it makes everything just sound huge. Rob Halford is sounding even better than he did on the previous album, which is just ridiculous. I mean, when I heard The Serpent and the King for the first time, I totally freaked out, especially when he started singing the first verse. And then that stained glass-esque chorus, I was kind of wondering if they might have resorted to some studio magic, because he sounds like 70s Rob in that part. He's just absolutely incredible on the entire album, and I guess that's why he's the metal god. Now, of course, as a guitarist, I am feeling all kinds of spoiled because I have a ton of juicy bits to sink my teeth into. Riffs, melodic lines, harmonies, solos. It's a blast to listen to, and it's going to be fun to learn some of these parts because they sound awesome and it feels so good to play them along with the record. So what I want to do with this video is to go over my favorite riffs so far, and I'll even include a really cool guitar harmony because it's just so good. So let me start with the title track because it's just classic Judas Priest. So it's a pretty simple riff, but it sounds so awesome, and it's deceptively tricky. Both the intro and the main riff are pedal point riffs in the key of A minor, and we're tuned down a half step, so the tones are actually in A flat. Now the intro is just diatonically ascending three note groupings played with a staccato feel, and power chord stabs that descend on the first repeat and ascend on the second. The main riff features an open A pedal point and dyads on top, kind of like what they did on Ram It Down. Metallica did a similar thing on Lux Eterna, except that one moves in only one direction. The Invincible Shield riff alternates between ascending and descending dyads, so that there's more of a sense of movement, kind of like being in a whirlwind. Before going into the verse, the band stops, and Richie plays an extended version of that three-note motif in the open position. in a way that reminds me a bit of the Sentinel from Defenders of the Faith. The second riff I want to look at is from the song As God Is My Witness, and this is what's commonly referred to as a scorcher. This one reminds me a bit of Leather Rebel, with the same kind of pedal point and top note picking. So it's a bit of an updated version of that riff in a way, but this one is just a little more complex as it uses an evil sounding tritone and some nice octave jumps for that vintage Priest vibe. The next riff is Trial by Fire, and this is definitely more of a contemporary Judas Priest riff, a little bit like Spectre, with a nice chugging rhythm. And what I really like about the way they arrange this riff is how they blend single notes with power chords seamlessly so that it has both heaviness and clarity. They play a different version of it on the verse, which I think is a really clever bit of arranging on their part. It goes something like this. And on the repeat, there's a nice harmony a third higher to make it stand out a little more. It also makes it sound more majestic with that extra layer. The next one is from that awesome first single, Panic Attack. And it's an absolute killer of a song, and from what I saw on YouTube from the first show of the tour, it's a sick opener. And again, that turbine before the verse, man, maybe it's from having listened to Turbo Lover way too many times back in the day, but I still get an adrenaline rush when I hear it. The guitars in this song are pure classic heavy metal, with moving pedal points, pull-offs, sometimes played with the slightest hint of a pinch harmonic, and even a nicely placed flat fifth in the chorus. The last riff I want to look at is from Giants in the Sky. This riff is so powerful, and with the drop C-sharp tuning, bluesy intervals, and grinding pace, it takes you back to Black Sabbath, but with a very modern heavy sound that is unmistakably Judas Priest. And this one also has two riffs back to back. The intro riff, which I just played, is actually the pre-chorus riff. And I have to point out how cool that is from an arrangement standpoint. This is the kind of thing that you get from decades of experience. And it just shows that they're not merely doing metal by numbers, but actually trying to be creative within their realm. The second riff picks up from there, but it's not a main riff because they only play this one time as a bridge to the verse. And again, very cool composing and arranging. Fight of Your Life takes me back to Better By You, Better Than Me from Stained Class. And I just love the band's vibe on that album. So I really like this one a lot. It also feels a little bit like a nod to Kiss's God of Thunder. And here again, they do that very Judas Priest thing where the riff is played in one key for the intro and then in another key when the band comes in. It's a simple but effective way to make that transition more impactful. So in this case, they started by playing it in A, and then when it picks up, they play it a fourth lower in E. I mentioned earlier that I also wanted to talk about one of the album's awesome guitar harmonies. And for that, we'll go back to the title track because it has an excellent guitar harmony that takes me back to that 80s twin guitar style that I just love so much. What they're doing here is a pretty standard harmony in thirds, but they're in two different parts of the fretboard, so you get a bit of a different articulation in some parts, and the way it blends together is what makes it sound the way it does as a whole. So let's start with the accompaniment, which in the music video is being played by Glenn Tipton in what I feel is a very strong scene, as it shows he's still able to play to a degree and still very much involved with the band. And it's sort of a passing the torch in a way as he helps lay the canvas for Andy and Richie's harmonized lead part. I'm not gonna lie, that part kind of got me. Got a little emotional when I first saw that. So the chords are B, A, E, G, and F sharp. The first two times around, the chords ring out for two bars each. And then the next two times, they're played as palm muted eighth notes to build up the intensity and give a sense of what I call racing to the finish. And now let's look at the lead guitars. So the part that seems to stand out a bit more is played by Andy Sneap live, and it goes like this. Richie plays the harmony a third higher, and he plays it up here like this. So this is where I'm at after having listened to these songs for a few days. And of course, there's so much left to explore, and we haven't even talked about any of the guitar solos. So please do let me know if there's one you'd like me to cover or break down, because ultimately, this channel isn't only about what I like, but especially about what you like and what sort of things you're interested in. So thank you all so much for watching. Cheers.